Of all the things that give people chills during a flight, trembling drinks, the momentary shaking of the fuselage, the noise of luggage dislodging above your head, and abrupt changes in altitude, in a word, turbulence is the scariest of them all. However, is our instinctual fear of turbulence justified? Can it really cause a plane to plummet thousands of feet through the air and actually crash? When talking about fluids, like air and water, turbulence refers to rapid changes in the speed and pressure of the fluid. In more technical terms, inertial forces dominate viscous forces when turbulence occurs. Although turbulence frequently occurs in various forms, from the smoke rising from a cigarette to atmospheric circulation, the term turbulence strikes particular fear in the minds of air travelers. Turbulence in an airplane is mainly caused by the interaction of jet streams, with slower-moving winds creating regions of uneven wind. This kind of turbulence is aptly called clear air turbulence, or CAT, as pilots cannot see it. In other situations, a plane can hit turbulence during stormy weather or a thunderstorm. A smaller plane running into the wake of a larger plane can also experience turbulence. Basically, whenever a plane enters a region where the prevailing winds are not behaving normally, it's bound to sustain a little battering. While turbulence may scare passengers into praying for Jesus, it's very rare for turbulence to actually bring a plane down. Airplane turbulence is classified into three categories: mild, moderate, and severe, although they aren't clearly defined due to a lack of objectivity. In mild turbulence, an airplane might sustain a few feet of altitude loss. While this is a bit scary for children and people who don't frequently fly, mild turbulence is routine and considered nothing more than a minor inconvenience. Moderate turbulence may entail a deviation of 10 to 20 feet in altitude and can last for 10 to 15 minutes. This can unnerve even frequent flyers and cause their drinks to spill. For safety, passengers will likely be advised to put on their seatbelts. Severe turbulence is the nastiest form of turbulence and may cause the plane to drop by 80 to 100 feet, while a significant rattling noise will be heard in the fuselage. Severe turbulence also requires immediate corrective actions by the pilots to steer clear. Severe turbulence may break bones, cause injuries, or even inflict fatal wounds in rare cases, all of which can be avoided by following simple safety guidelines. Fortunately, the chances of running into severe turbulence are slim to none. In fact, most flyers, even pilots, don't encounter severe turbulence over the course of their flying career. Furthermore, modern commercial airplanes are also built to withstand harsh weather conditions. There have been instances where the external surface of planes have sustained serious damage, but the internal fuselage remained completely untouched. It can be said that a plane flying into turbulence is like driving a car on a bumpy road. It's usually nothing more than a nuisance. Turbulence is certainly something that pilots must be aware of, but it is primarily an issue affecting passengers' comfort, not their safety.